All right, so now we jump in to Mega Man 5, which I have quite an affinity for as well. I think Mega Man 5 is a great game. And we'll watch the intro here, and we'll let it ride for a minute so you can see. The bad guy in this game, presumably, or purportedly, is Proto Man. I love that shot of Dr. Light getting kidnapped by Proto Man and his scarf falling. Alright, so that little intro sets the stage and we'll jump in. Now, with Mega Man 5, you can start in a few different places. I like to start with Starman. Here, you can jump really high, because there is no gravity. Yep. Kevin asked if I was on a satellite. I answered in the affirmative.
It changed the design of the charge.
Yeah, the bullet's bigger. Now if you get hit when you're charging, it will knock the charge out of you. So that's a different gameplay mechanic. You want to deal with these guns before they pop up. This is a tough one. All right, so these little letter tablets, what are they? Why are they here? They're, if you can spell here in the menu Mega Man 5, you will get Beat. Beat is Mega Man's bird. You see. Tough jump, that's a really tough jump. This is a tough jump too. Because again, just like when you're underwater, you have way too much momentum. So there's four guns here, we can get rid of all of them before we continue. Little AT-ST type walker enemy. This can be really hairy, so you want to get out of here as soon as possible, because these guys will just swarm the shit out of you. And we are to Starman's lair. Now, Starman, like Woodman in Mega Man 2, like Skullman in Mega Man 4, uses a shield, but he is way easier to beat than those other two enemies. So for beating Starman, you get Star Crash Plus, or Star Crush Plus, the Super Hour, which we'll show you later. Next stage is Gravity Man stage. Now, Gravity Man has one of the most interesting, if not the most single most interesting stage in any Mega Man game. And you're gonna find out why. But it also has these arrows right over there. As you can see, these arrows change their formation, allowing you to go up and down. Oop. Well, I don't know what I'm doing. There we go. So you can avoid those guys. Those guys can't be destroyed. You just gotta kind of dodge them best you can. These particular enemies, deal with them. You don't try to go under them. They can haunt you if you do. And we'll deal with that. We'll go down. Now these guys take a ton of damage, you don't really want to, they also give a ton of damage as you can see, so you don't really want to trifle with them, just skip them if you can. Now this, you just jump and you end up upside down. And here you're going to want to grab that M as we continue our way towards getting beat. Pretty cool stage, right? I love it. I love the upside down ladder as well. Make sure to press over. So we're at Gravity Man stage. Now Gravity Man's easy enough actually to be with the Mega Buster, but we can use the Star Crash or Star Crash 2 to our advantage here. You just have to get close to him you don't want to collide with him. You just want to be near enough to him where the Star Crash can hit him like that. That was not the ideal. There, and that's it. And he's done. And Gravity Man's down. Now, Gravity Man gives you a weapon called the Gravity Hold that is not all that useful. It's kind of a corny weapon, actually, that I'll show you. I won't even show it to you until we use it. So you can see exactly what I mean. Starting to run out of some ideas here in terms of weapons at this point in the series. So from here, we're going to go to Gyro Man. Cool little stage here. Take the lift up. Cruising along, those enemies, obviously their shields will block. These guys you're gonna wanna avoid since they can't be killed. Let me continue along, kill those guys with one hit. Those little chicken enemies are interesting, we'll just grab the afterlife. Didn't really need it. Let these guys come to you. Don't rush, they'll knock you off the platform, then you can go up. Grab that just to be safe, climb up the ladder. Continue along up. Avoid most of that havoc by just taking the top path. And then for this guy, gotta go All right, so these guys can make some problems for you. So there, it's fine to die. You can actually get it without dying the A. You can jump back up. I didn't do it very well because I was actually just had gotten hit by an enemy. The brilliance of that, though, is that the checkpoint is right here, so you don't have to really worry about it. Okay, this part can be a little hectic as it moves by itself. Just got to use the leverage of the path below you to jump, but not jump too high and not to jump too late. Or you're going to hit those spikes and they'll kill you immediately. So we're getting close to the end here. We'll deal with this last gun here, and then we'll go to the gravity hold. And I'm going to show you what it's all about as we fight Gyro Man. It's kind of corny. And Gyro Man's easy enough, actually, to beat with the Mega Buster as well. So, much like, I guess, like Rain Flush in Mega Man 4, much like Centaur Flash in Mega Man 6, it's an attack that just takes up the whole screen. And so you just use it. You don't have to aim it. You just have to make sure that you just don't want to spam it or you're going to waste it. You just have to use it. Boom, 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 and Gyro Man is no more. So with that, Gyro Man is finished. And we'll acquire his weapon, which is the Gyro Attack. We'll also get the Rush Jet, as you can see here. And with that, we will move on to Crystal Man. Now, Crystal Man, his stage is a pain in the ass. But we're gonna see what we can do here. So if you destroy those things before destroying the ball will bounce. If you destroy the ball, it'll destroy the base. So you wanna destroy the ball. I'm sorry I keep looking at my phone. I was getting text messages here. Things are happening, things are happening. The situation is fluid. Alright, so this is why Crystal Man's stage is just a straight pain in my ass. You just have to time your jumps really carefully here. And wait for these things to stop. And there's really no like rhyme or reason to it. You just gotta watch and wait for gaps. And if you rush or don't make the right jump, you're just gonna smash right into a hole and you have to do it again. So sometimes I just wait until I'm comfortable. All right, we're through. We're gonna have to do one more of those and it's gonna be way harder. But at least we're through that and we don't have to worry about that anymore. Eddie giving us some energy. Remember we were introduced to Eddie in Mega Man 4. These are Diamond or Crystal Joes. A play on Sniper Joe, or Hammer Joe from Mega Man 3. Sniper Joe, of course, Mega Man 1, 2. So again, we're closer to the crystal things now, so we're gonna have to just be extra careful. So we're dealing with those guys. So we just wait, we wait, we wait. We go through. Deal with the enemies first. Concentrate on both of these things at the same time. It's not worth it. Okay, we're through. Whew, hate that shit. It's a pain in the ass. Deal with that guy. Take this up. So here, grab the E-Tank, and then continue on our way. Oh, so there's an M tank up there. M tanks are master tanks there. That's the rush coil in this game. It sucks. The master tank fills up all your weapon energy. All of them. And you want to save it for Wily's Castle. So here on this particular drop, we're going to want to get over to the left, I believe, to get the token for V as we continue along. Remember, we're filling up our Mega Man V tokens to get Rush. Rush will be very useful, especially on the last boss in the game. Oop, that was stupid. Ugh, I'm in bad shape here. All right. I don't know if I want to just commit suicide here or what. Well, let's try to see what we can do. Why not? So gyro attack can actually be controlled in the air, so I can actually send it upwards at will. Get away from this guy. And, well, good. If you stay close to him, he's not going to attack, so you can stay on top of him. And that's the end of Crystal Man. I love the shimmering of the gems. It's pretty cool. So we get Crystal Eye, and with that, we're going to move on to Napalm Man. So these tigers do a lot of damage and they're a pain in the ass. So you wanna, and when you shoot, they're gonna attack you. So use a full attack on them and kill them from afar before they pounce. That's why they have that energy right away, because they know you're gonna learn some hard lessons the first time you play. Here, these bombs come at you and you just need to shoot them from afar. With the long ladder. This E-Tank can just be gotten by going through an invisible wall. Right there. Getting a lot of text messages here. Life. Back out in the forest. These guys need to be hit in the head. Damage. Remember, we're going to need this N, so grab that. Just avoid the. We don't really need the extra life. These missiles should be destroyed from afar. Ugh, jumped right into that. So I'm using my invincibility there to play games there. You don't want to try that unless you're experienced in Mega Man, what I just did. Oop. So these missiles, kind of let them come out and go back down and jump over them. And we are at Napalm Man. So the Crystal Eye is an interesting attack in that if it misses, it'll bounce and make a bunch of different shards that will then bounce around. So it's somewhat useful, but you want to try to stay on Napalm Man if you can and just attack him directly so you have at least control over what's going on, because otherwise you have a situation like this. I can't attack again until, oh, right into him. Let's see if I can put him away. That should be the end. Ooh, that was close, but that's good. Check my text messages. Sorry. Answering a bunch of text messages here. Trying to multitask. All right, so with napalm bombs from Napalm Man, we're going to go to Stone Man. Okay. Continuing to cruise through the intro here to Stone Man stage. Now, this is a thing you're gonna want to pay attention to. That's you're never gonna know that's there, but you have to go through this to get the G. That's like really the only well hidden token in the game for a beat. Keep cruising, we'll get rid of these guys behind us so they don't continue to stalk us. Taking a little too much damage here. Gotta cool down, we'll use that energy up there. These things are mines basically, they'll explode, so you wanna just stay away from them. These mice are too small, too low to the ground to fight with the regular attacks on their level, so you're gonna want to use a special attack. Might as well grab this. Oh god. He's got me trapped. That was stupid. I shouldn't have done that. That's what happens when you get a little overzealous. Okay. Climb up the ladder and draw these guys out. You can get that extra level if you need it, we really don't need it. And then we'll get rid of these guys. Brings you up diagonally. So we can get that E-tank and we're gonna do that now. And the way we do that is just we simply use the rush jet. You can also use the super arrow if you want, but I just feel like I have a little more control with the rush jet. Here's Eddie again. What has he got for us? More shit I don't need. Stoneman. Now, Stoneman, not surprisingly, is weak to bombs. Napalm bombs. And we're gonna use them in a specific way. So you can try to hit him directly with them, and you can also put them where he lands. Oh shit, he's landing right on top of me. So it's cool to try to set them up basically where he lands, and so he's dead and we'll get the Power Stone weapon from him. Sorry, I'm just gonna answer more text messages because I'm getting bombarded here. Okay. Stowman's done. We go to Charge Man. Now, Charge Man's an interesting enemy because this is actually the other place other than Starman and Gravity Man where I think you could realistically start your cycle. The reason I say that is because we're going to fight Charge Man with our arm cannon anyway. He is weak to Power Stone, but it is just hard to use on him. And he's just not that hard to fight without it. So if you're looking for a place that's not Gravity Man or Charge Man or whatever to start with, this is probably the place you're going to want to start. It's probably the only other realistic place you have. Of course, this game's not super hard overall, where you can probably fight most of the enemies. There's like no Pharaoh Man or Shadow Man or Quick Man or something like that where you're really going to have some problems in this particular game. These new train mets are pretty cool. I like them a lot. The background's really cool too. Clouds are whirling by as the train charges down the tracks. Now we're inside the train. And I like, I don't know, it might be subtle for you watching at home, but I like how the screen goes up and down a little bit to represent the movement of the trains. There's just a lot of cool design choices in this game. With Gravity Man stage, with this stage, with Starman stage, I think that there's a great design, overarching design aesthetic in this game. Some weapons aren't so unique, but the stages certainly are. So here we're gonna wanna get the A. Probably should have cleared some of these enemies out first. Getting a little hasty. So here we are at Charge Man again. We could use Power Stone, but we're not going to. We'll just stick with what we know. Oh man, rip me up. Shit. This next shot should do it. All right, so Charge Man is finished. Okay. So we have the charge kick, and now we're going to move on to Wave Man, the final boss. Sorry. Okay. Sorry. Truth be told, I just got these text threads going on with my uncle about I play in a pretty serious fantasy league with him. Fantasy Football League, and there's things going on with that, and my girlfriend's text messaging, she's like, these things can't wait, I guess. And I don't mind answering those, so I do apologize if I'm being rude. That is not my intent. Oops, I didn't mean to do that either. So the steam coming out of the ground does indeed hurt you, so you have to kind of cause it to come out by getting close to it, so you have to just kind of be patient there. These bubbles, so the little bubbles that appear, are tiny. And you can't stand on them for very long, but they're used as platforms to use quickly to get from big balloon or big bubble to big bubble. So here we're going to jump onto this little cart, and this is a kind of a very unique. So again, we're talking about unique stages and things that are just different in Mega Man 5. This is another one of those things. There's nothing quite like this in any of the Mega Man games. I always kind of got a kick out of this. These Sniper Joes riding on these Ski-Doos. Gotta avoid these fish best you can. Through that section, we're gonna have to fight this little mini boss real quick. Oh no, taking a beating. All right, there we go. And now I'm getting another text message from someone else. Sorry about that. There. All right, so you're gonna see that there's no ceremony. We have beat now, but you don't really know it unless you look at the menu. Uh-oh. Whew, just made it. I'm gonna commit suicide here against Waveman and let him do his thing here. Alright, I don't really have enough energy to fight him, so we'll just let him do his thing and then I'll just stand here. Okay, perfect. Okay, so let's go into the menu. We're going to use the Charge Kick. Charge Kick is another interesting weapon similar to Top Spin Mega Man 3 that you'll use as your body. So you're going to slide in enemies. You'll see that we have beat on the bottom now. So you're going to have to sacrifice a little bit here. That's the end of Wave Man. See, Wave Man uses his harpoon attack and then also his wave attack as well. So he is dynamic. Similar to Bubble Man in Mega Man 2. So we'll go to Proto Man's castle now. Okay, let's rock. Oop, made a huge mistake there already. Remember the tip that I gave you on Napalm Man stage, which was to kill those guys from afar if you can, because they'll pounce right on you. Now this guy's gonna get over it, so we're gonna have to be a little more clever. That guy on the platform is positioned high enough where if I shoot him, he's just gonna get over it. So you want to bait these guys out, these explosives. You don't have to deal with them. And then here we can use the Super Hour for the first time, although we could use Rush Coil as well. The Super Hour is basically just a platform. See? You can also use it as a weapon if you like. So here we'll use, since we took a bit of damage, we'll draw him out, and then we'll get back up there and grab these things and fill up. So we're back to how we started, which is nice. So we use the jet there, and then we can use Super Arrow again. Tons of slowdown. A lot going on the screen at once. And again, what castle will be complete without obnoxious disappearing block puzzles? Thinking about how I want to play this. Because I could... I can just get it over a little bit more. Just skip it. Take care of that guy from afar. Use the super arrow. This particular enemy will not actually hit you if you don't move into it. It will just circle around you. Because we went back over to the left, he respawned. And we are to enemy number one. Now, we're going to be fighting these guys called Darkman over and over again, basically. We'll use the water wave on the first one from Waveman. And that's the end of him. And on to the next. So you have a choice of ladders here. I took the wrong one. You want to take the left one. Just get through. And then here we have the option again to use the rush coil or the super arrow. I like using the super arrow and things like that. These shorter jumps works fine for me. Here. These platforms are moving, so you gotta be careful. And again, you wanna kinda be careful here not to stay in one place for too long. You're gonna have to deal with these guys dropping shit on you. Fuck. Damn it. So with these particular skull enemies, you wanna kinda keep hopping around. I gotta start the beginning. It sucks. Okay. Let's do it again. No big deal.
Alright, so we're kind of back to where we were. Gotta be careful on these jumps. And again, you want to just kind of try to keep moving if you can. And you can start kind of peppering the right side of the screen. Hit enemies before they appear, just kind of hope that you hit a couple of them. Here we can take out these enemies. Let's just grab that real quick. Could use that for sure. Get rid of that. And then here, we can use the super hour to get over, and we can actually just fill that up. And then as we drop back down, we can take out these enemies. Grab that, make sure to turn back before you hit the spikes. You're gonna wanna do the same thing here with this energy. The extra life you can grab if you want with the rush jet or the super arrow, but we're gonna keep moving. Jump up and grab the ladder here. And then this last guy you can just ignore. This is gonna be a tough one because... Man, taking a fucking beating. Bueno. This guy just killed himself. Uh-oh. Gotta go, gotta go. Oh my god, I can't wait to die again. Oh dear. Alright, well we'll start at the halfway point at least. We're not too far off. Sorry about that. Back up here. We left that for last time, which is nice, so we can go back and get it now. Remember, if you, with the exception of Mega Man 1, if you grab one of those things, they're not going to be there the next time you come through, unless you left it, or unless you died. Since, man, I'm struggling again here. Incredible. Some things were not meant to be, my friends. Ah! Man, I totally missed time, that whole thing. All right. This guy just kind of runs around with a shield. He's not really that hard to fight. He does get faster, though. As you can see. Alright, so that's the end of him, and we'll move on to the next stage in Darkman's Castle. Or in Protoman's Castle, I'm sorry. So those guys are fatigued. I think it's because I did all these Let's Plays back-to-back, to be honest. So those guys will swarm and be all on you, so you just kind of want to keep moving or deal with them quickly. Remember, those mines are going to be there. Just kill that guy for fun.
gun. Make sure, remember that these guys are gonna fire at you. Here we're gonna have to be quick-footed. So you messed one of these up like I just did. You're gonna wanna go back down the ladder and just respawn them. Or you can use rush coil if you wanted to, but it's easier to do it that way, I think. So this part gets a little hairy. What you could do here, I sometimes sacrifice my life around here to just get these, but you could also just use the super hour to get through. At least until that point. And then patiently either fire away at these guys or whatever you want to do. Okay. And we're good. And this guy, he's got me cornered. Damn it. He's gonna respawn. Oh god. Come on. There we go. So you can grab the E-tank quickly and get out of there. And then we're gonna do this part here. We have some more enemies to deal with. Not surprisingly, it's gonna be a little more difficult this time. Because we're not gonna go off the beaten path this time like I did last time, it should be more manageable for you, dealing with the enemies. And here we are. So this is the third iteration of Darkman. And on him we're gonna use the gyro attack. And remember, oh, so he can stop, he has a time stopper you can avoid though, unlike, you know, Centaur Man's or whoever else is Brightman's. Uh-oh, he's gonna nail me here. So we'll use the E-Tank real quick. As we have quite a few of them. And we'll continue along with the... Ah, man, I can't believe I'm getting hit by these so much. And that's the end of him. A little more difficult than I want it to be, but nonetheless. How are you doing, Kevin?
Excellent.
Glad to hear that. Struggling a little bit with Mega Man 5, huh?
How are you doing with this?
I'm okay. I'm getting tired, so I'm not playing quite as.
That's a cool looking castle.
Yeah, Proto Man's castle.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not playing quite. I'm fatigued, so I'm losing a little bit of my steam here as we get towards the end.
Two more levels left, then. Right.
I got to get through this, and then we go to Wily's castle. Not that I want to spoil anything for anyone. So here. Yeah, here you're trying to destroy these blocks here, and this is basically the whole stage. And then you slide through. There's something wrong about that whistle, though. There's something not right about it. No? So, real Proto Man comes in and saves the day. And we'll call, we can use Beat here to help us out a little bit. Getting beat. So as you can see, he's like a combination kind of some of the different dark men that we fought earlier. Should probably use this. Oops, I forgot to go back to Beat. And Beat will take him out, and that's it. The fake Proto Man has been exposed and destroyed. Dark Man has been destroyed. The real Proto Man lives. And you damn well know what's going to happen now. Damn you, Wily.
Oh, shit. No, that's the castle.
That's the castle right there. Yeah, no doubt about it. E-tank right there. Grab it. Oh, that was stupid. Forgot about that. It's funny, the last time I played the game when I was screwing around with it, I did the same exact thing. You always want to go right. But you shouldn't. That's why it's there. It's playing on you. So we go left. Again, these things that you can't destroy. We haven't seen those enemies in a while, but here they are. And I remember we still have to fill everything up here. We'll probably use that M-Tank at some point. Let's see. Grab this energy, use the super arrow. Careful to jump there so that you know, don't hit those spikes, die instantly. This part gets a little crazy. Here we can use Rush Coil. And then here, you want to go up these, but not yet. You actually want to destroy this guy over here. And then you can use, because he'll shoot upwards and just knock you off. And then you can use the Rush Coil. And then you could time your jump well enough there, which I didn't. You can actually get to that thing on top, which makes it just a little easier. And then we can cruise on. Okay. Very good. So here you're going to be careful. This is kind of straight out of Dustman stage in Mega Man 4. they made it, they might as well use it again. I'm sure it was the rationale behind this particular part of the stage. Okay. Slide under. And then get over to the edge quickly and it'll stop. Okay, so we're at the first boss in Wily's castle. On this guy, we're gonna use Crystal Eye. Now, if you want to be extra judicious with the Crystal Eye here, you can actually use the pea shooter to draw those things out. But that's just a little too much menu switching for me. So, just one more. That's the end of him. We move on to the next stage of Wily's Castle. Carefully. Sorry, I'm being quiet. I'm just very tired. But I'd like to get through this for you. Oh! Jeez, man, I'm dying in stupid ways here. I do apologize about that. These guys are being very loud, too. So I'm sorry about that. That's bleeding through. Kevin's losing his mind. Oh my god! Oh god, I gotta concentrate. I'm leaning forward now. I'm sorry that this is happening. Okay. This is the one. How do I still have 8 lives? I feel like I've died like 5 times. Really bad. All right. Keep going. Jeez Louise, I don't know why that was so hard. Oh, that's not even where I died before. No, this is where I died. Okay. Very careful. Very good. Okay. We'll leave that there because I'll probably die again. I'll need it. Actually, might need that. What were you, is what you were watching out there the final version of it?
No.
Is it just a clip?
It's like a full.
It's a full thing.
Yeah, but it's like there's still a lot of things that need to be added in it. It's the first time it's ever been put together.
Cool. I want to see it.
Yeah.
Is it good?
It's good.
For everyone at home, we'll show you what we're talking about shortly. I'm sure.
I think the noise that you may have heard was me seeing myself for the first
time. Oh, you're in it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Actually, I think I knew that. Okay. So we're cruising along. More and more. Further and further. So here, we can do a few things. I like to just use Power Stone. It's not the ideal weapon. It doesn't do much damage to him, but you don't really use this weapon any other time. This might be actually the first time you've ever even seen it. And then if you stand to the far right of the screen and use Rush Jet, you can just go up like this and then jump. And then here we are. And again, you're gonna wanna use Power Stone here. Because you wanna go into this fight, you know, hurting. I think it takes like 12 or 14 hits and it'll hit him twice per. So this might be the last one, there we go. And then for this particular enemy we're gonna fight here, we're gonna use the gyro attack. Okay, we're almost through. And he's dead. So now we're going. We're almost to the end. And I'm sorry that I'm losing energy out there. It's a very, very long day. Very tired.
You do good, though.
Thank you, Kevin. I appreciate that.
Does that feel good?
Feels nice, thank you. Okay. You don't have to continue to do that.
No, it's fine. I can do it for a couple minutes. It's hot.
It is hot.
How much longer do you have?
15 minutes. A lot of anger right now.
I don't like them.
No?
Yeah, I get fucked up.
All right, so here we're gonna do the old Mega Man tradition once more of fighting all the enemies. Did you see this fight, by the way? Gravity Man? I thought you'd enjoy this fight.
You. Is there no, like, Flash Man that can, like, freeze him?
No. Not in this game. Mega Man 6 will have an enemy like that. Called Centaur Man.
That's good.
Thank you. I just love that fight. I think that fight's so clever.
I like that the, like, things that teleport you there are broken.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they break when you destroy them.
Right.
Here, we'll use Charge Kick. Remember, you have to sacrifice the body a little bit here. Just like playing a sport. Gotta sacrifice the body, Kevin.
Worth it.
Here we'll fight Stone Man. We'll use napalm bombs on him.
Gutman.
Yeah, definitely. He's huge, just like him. There he is. You like him?
Yeah.
On Napalm Man, you're saying? So that should be the end of Stone Man. And then we'll climb back up. And we'll fight Gyro Man, of course. You're gonna use Gravity Hold on him, which is a stupid weapon. I'm good, thank you. He's a little bitch, though, as you can see. Starman. You could use Water Wave on him, but there's really no reason.
Just gotta be patient. He's not hard at all. That's it. Starman is done.
I like when you explain these things, because it's like your... What's the guy that drew the little bushes?
Oh, Bob Ross.
You sound like Bob Ross. Oh. That's fine.
Thank you, I appreciate it. That's very...
Like, no, you're just very talented. We don't I appreciate that. It's not that easy for us.
I appreciate that. You're going to use gyro attack on him, so we're going to finally start using the mystery tank, which will fill up all our weapons. It's not so much a mystery now. It was maybe a mystery at some point. All right, so now we're all full and we can go to gyro attack. And Crystal Man is no more. There's only two left. Napalm Man. And for Napalm Man, remember, you're gonna use Crystal Eye. Well, if you were here before, then you knew that you were supposed to use the Crystal Eye. And then finally, we'll get through Charge Man, who will fight straight up. It's funny because Charge Man can be really easy, or like just depending on what he does. He has a real pattern, so. I try to stay as far away from him as possible to give yourself enough room to deal with him. And that's the end of him. And then we are off to Wily. You have to get is usually up to his cockpit. Remember, if you hit those spikes, you'll die instantaneously. This will only be his first form of three. That's why it's so easy. So we'll move on, fight Wily two more times.
What system was this originally on?
NES. These are all on NES. Very good.
Yeah. There's so much more going on.
I agree. Just got through. Fuck out. She's an e-tank. So here you can use actually Super Arrow as a weapon if you want. You don't have to. Does a lot of damage though.
And then we'll get his final form. And for this, we'll need beat. Get him! I love beat. Beat's the dude. Come on, man. Get at him. Beats the homie for sure. Use E tank just to be careful. So you just gotta be patient. That's all. Unfortunately, I can't charge my arm cannon while I am using beat, so can't find him. So I'm stuck with just pea shooter shots, which is fine. Get him! Get him! I like when he tracks him quickly, it's cool. One more just in case. I don't think I'll need it, but you never know. I don't want to make you sit through this again. All right, we're almost there. Hell, when he misses. There we go. Beat. Get him. That's it. Mega Man 5 is completed. And we will enjoy the ending together. Sorry I wasn't playing too well, but I hope you enjoyed the game nonetheless. Sorry also I was being distracted by a bunch of text messages about fantasy football and all sorts of imminent shit that I had to answer apparently. And for the multiple deaths, but I hope you enjoyed, nonetheless, the playthrough of Mega Man 5. Maybe I'll go back in the future and do a cleaner one, but in the meantime, I wanted to show you the game. I love this game. I think it's a great, great and underrated game, along with 6, which I'm going to do next. Let's watch the ending together. I'll be quiet. Enjoy. Thank you for joining us. Remember, there are Let's Plays up for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, unless you are watching 5 the day comes out, in which case 6 will be up tomorrow. Otherwise, enjoy all of them. Let me know what you think, and we'll see you next time.